Enter, ye who dare.
We have some bad news.
We found something. Number two came up to ask Miss Bean if she had a bigger punch bowl, and she noticed her bedroom door was open.
Another creepy collage.
It's like Daddy always says, if you want something done right, pay someone a lot of money to do it for you. Now, why don't you all strap on some oat bags and go poop huge green turds in the street like the sad old mares you are?
Your very housemate, Libby Putney. You know her as Chanel Number 5.
Chanel Number 5's real name is Libby Putney?
Said, however, for her mother.
Wait, what?
Yes, as it turns out, her mother has quite the criminal record.
I knew it. Looks like the bitch apple doesn't fall far from the bitch tree. Thank you, gentlemen. Grace is the killer, and this file proves it. I'm not sure if she got knocked up that night or a couple days after, but almost exactly 9 months later, she had you.
No, that's not possible.
You always suspected you were the baby in the bathtub, didn't you? But it didn't quite add up, did it? This, however, does. Your mother changed her name from Bethany Stevens to Mary Mulligan in a feeble attempt to put the sins of her youth behind her. But I guess popping you out drove her off the deep end, because that's when her criminal record gets really interesting. She was arrested for shoplifting, petty larceny, grand larceny, drunk driving with a baby in her lap, drunk driving with a baby on top of her car, and possession of methamphetamine with intent to distribute. Obviously appalled, your douchebag father sued for custody and won. Your saint of a mother died a year later. She was driving drunk, obviously, and decided to wrap her car around a tree.
That's a lie. My dad said that she died in a fire.
Fiery car crash. He probably wanted to spare you the pain of finding out who your skank mom really was. See, do you want to know my theory? You thought you were the baby in the bathtub, so you decided to come back to Kappa Kappa Tau and kill everybody. Well, guess what, Grace? You're not the baby. So you can stop murdering everybody and accept the fact that your dumb dead mother was nothing more than a drunk, degenerate slut. What's going on here? What in God's name are you wearing?
Chanel, she's wearing my clothes. She's wearing my underwear.
Oh, shut up, Number 5. Your underwear's probably relieved to be touching actual human genitals.
Not that it matters. I wouldn't put it past him to hunt all of us down one by one.
Let's wait in here if she makes it downstairs to make sure the killer isn't still here.
I had all three of you fooled, didn't I? You got me. I'm not pregnant. But it doesn't matter, because Chad still thinks that I am. And being that he already purchased our first-class airfare to the Hamptons, that means that I'll be the one attending Thanksgiving, where I'll have ample opportunity to get pregnant all weekend long. What did you say?
Hester, I am so sorry. I'm sorry you've had to go through life feeling like an outcast, and I'm sorry that I got angry that Chad's clearly chosen you over me. It's just that ever since you walked through those doors, I knew you were gonna be the one to take it all away from me.
Really?
No. You don't have to marry that psycho cow, Hester, because you don't have a baby on the way, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean.
I have killed for love, Chad. I've killed for our love.
What?
Chad, Hester was never pregnant. She just said that so you'd invite her to Thanksgiving with your family in the Hamptons. But then she had a little accident down the stairs.
Oh, what? Wait, are you saying you killed Hester?
Gravity killed Hester. I just gave her a little push.
I'm not a detective or anything, but what if Hester was never dead? and she just managed to escape.
That's not possible. I watched her fall down the stairs.
After she fell down the stairs, did you check her pulse?
No, Chad, because I'm not like a registered nurse.
You'll meet so many new and different women. So many wonderful women to go out with and break up with and move on from.
But you should be thankful that this table is too long for me to reach across and strangle you, bitch! And furthermore, I'm sorry that you had to sit through the most mean-spirited game of Pictionary in the history of Pictionary. I mean, no one deserves to be spoken to like that, particularly not by what is without a doubt the most awful family in America. Chad, your leathery excuse for a mother looks like an ostrich hide clutch from last season that somehow learned to talk. And Mr. Radwell, I have never seen anyone spend so much money to make a house look this tacky. I've honestly seen more tasteful decor at a Sizzler. And you, Thad, have a bright future ahead of you in the sex offender wing of a Supermax prison. And you, sir, give the kind, hardworking, deeply moral people who work in such a wonderful industry as Hollywood a bad name. Black Friday is about buying deliberately cheap, totally forgettable Christmas gifts for friends. The obvious cheapness of the gift makes them question our friendship and makes them way easier to manipulate as they try desperately to get back on my good side.
Thank you, Chanel.
Thank you.
Is this black toilet paper?
Yes, Merry Christmas, number 5. Then, once I bought a crap gift that will undermine their confidence in our friendship, I reward myself with an amazing gift for me. Amazing, a pair of mink albino boy shorts. Purchased for me, by me. And there's truly no better whale watching than a good old American doorbuster. You know, the kind that provides dangerous stampedes that dominate YouTube for at least a week and make me laugh and laugh. I bribed the dude who deals weed off the loading dock to let me in a half hour early. This really sends them into a frenzy. Torturing these soulless manatees of senseless consumerism brings me so much joy. And isn't joy what the holiday season's all about? Sorry, did you just put me on a timeout? You do realize I'm not 7, right? Let's review the facts, shall we? You have been utterly powerless to protect us from the Red Devil. Sort of a strange coincidence, isn't it? Seeing as how your primary motivation as dean of this school has been to shut down Kappa House. Well, behold, how badly you failed. Kappa House is alive and well, and it's your university that's been shut down. I think it's pretty safe to assume that your career is over. Now, if you'll excuse us, we're going to the mall to exercise our patriotic right to join hundreds of thousands of our fellow out-of-breath Americans in sweatpants as they make frenzied, ill-thought-out purchases of cheap, crappy garbage they can't afford and don't need. To deny us of that right would be un-American. Let's go, sluts! Try not to murder anyone else while we're gone, Dean Carpetmunch. I get number 5 a pair of 99-cent brass studs that'll turn her earlobes green and give her an infection, or a pair of $1.99 danglies that'll get caught in her sweater and tear her ear holes?
That's a really good question.
Okay, you know what? You guys, I don't understand why you have to get us the crappiest gifts possible and then make sure we know about it beforehand just to ruin the surprise.
Hello? The surprise is that you're getting anything at all. You guys should be happy you're even on my radar. Come on, let's get out of here.
Wait, where are we going?
To the Chrysler dealership across the street. I'm buying us all matching pink Jeeps.
Wait, what?
Yes, it's gonna be so fun. We can take our matching pink Jeeps on like an African safari or something.
How do we know that they're gonna have 4 identical pink Jeeps?
And how are we gonna get the Jeeps to Africa? I mean, are we gonna ship them or are we gonna take a fare?
I don't know, number 5, okay? Stop poking holes in the pink Jeep idea, please, and just accept the fact that I'm buying you all pink Jeeps. Take the win, number 5. Jeeps. We're locked in!
Oh, as if, number 5. Oh, hi.
Hello, Chanel. Why did you ask me to meet you here? And why are you carrying a bag clearly filled with chains?
Bondage. I would like to comment to all the so-called mainstream media, including weird websites that nobody has heard of who've used my name as clickbait. And to all the relentless, unwashed hordes on Twitter who have taken every opportunity to mock and attack me mercilessly from the safety of their stained futons, I offer the following heartfelt sentiment. You can all suck it! She kept saying something dork, saying I'm a dork or something dork. Number six. Hi, everyone on campus but me is a dork.
I called the company because I thought that the app was broken. You have to go meet this guy.
You should go. Any guy swiping right on you is a miracle. So go. Go meet this blind man. And when I'm done apologizing to Melanie, I'm gonna call Pope Francis because we now have proof of God's existence in this universe. Melanie, I just wanna say that I hope you rot in hell, bitch!
What are you doing? I thought you came here to apologize.
Never! I apologize for nothing. Melanie Dorcas is the killer! What? Oh, don't look so surprised, Mask. All evidence points to you. You heard what number six said. She saw someone walking around campus in a veil, muttering, dork, 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 Dorcas and Dorcas!
So she suddenly can't remember her own last name?
I called my travel agent, who called Alaska Charters LLC, who confirmed that you, Melanie Dorcas, took a seaplane back to campus 1 week before the killing started.
So?
So you're obviously the killer! You came back from your weird Arctic compound to get revenge on Kappa House because you're hideous and think that I put acid in your spray tanner when I didn't!
I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't kill anybody.
Can it, Dorcas? I know it was you. Have fun in hell, bitch. And FYI, this is probably gonna hurt a lot.
Wait, stop. She's not the killer.
What are you talking about? Of course she is.
No, she's not. I swear, we have proof. It's Hester. Hester is the Red Devil.
So sorry. Stop
recording. We, the jury, find the defendants.
Objection!
Zoblin, there's no more objections. The trial is over.
What? When did that happen?
You were asleep. Judge Joe Brown, we, the Chanels, hereby declare this trial a farce. I was under the impression that I had the inalienable right to a jury of my peers. Look at these hippos. These are not my peers. I'm a hot, rich, skinny chick, which makes me entitled to a jury of hot, rich, skinny chicks to see how awesome I am. And to see that the three of us are innocent!
Your Honor, we the jury find that the defendants are guilty on all 47 counts.
Order in the court.
Deal with
order.
This is a travesty, Judge Mathis. This is a kangaroo court. And I am choosing to ignore this verdict.
What? You can't ignore the verdict?
What verdict? See, this is me ignoring the verdict. For like the millionth time, my dad is super gross rich. Like disgusting rich. He'll have me out of prison in no time.
Chanel, your parents abandoned you. They legally disowned you 3 weeks ago and filed an amicus brief with the prosecution stating that they think that you are a serial killer. They also want to sue you for the time that you drove your Range Rover into their living room because you didn't want to walk all the way up the driveway.
It is such a long driveway.
Don't worry, Miss Oberman. You ladies are not going to prison.
Thank you.
You're going to an asylum.
What?
You know, you three are the worst human beings that I have ever encountered. You have absolutely no regard for anyone but yourselves. You're rude, entitled, narcissistic, racist, and insane. You elected to represent yourselves in a capital murder case, despite lacking even a basic understanding of the law. And then you mostly slept through your own trial. That's crazy. Your entire defense consisted of you screaming at the jury that you didn't kill anybody, and then threatening to kill them if they found you guilty. That is crazy behavior. Chanel, you're crazy! Ladies, please stand. Stand up! Chanel Oberlin, Sadie Swenson, Libby Putney.
I'm sorry, I keep forgetting your real name is Libby Putney.
I sentence you to life in prison at the Palmer Asylum for the Insane.